हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. आई एम कांदे सर एंड टुडेज इट इज़ अवर फिफ्थ लेक्चर इन स्टैंडर्ड 9. सो आई हार्टली वेलकम्स इन अवर टुडेज ऑनलाइन मैथमेटिक्स क्लास एंड वी वेर इन एक्सरसाइज 14.2. ऑलमोस्ट मैनी क्वेश्चंस आर सॉल्व एंड मैनी वेर गिवन इन होमवर्क ऑल्सो. I hope you successfully solve all of them. And if in case of any problem, you just take follow-up of that and try to solve it by any way. You can get solutions from same type of example also, so that you can know what is the method. And I have given hint also. So if you are having any problem in doing homework, then you can rewatch videos. Okay. Now let's look 15th sum. Today it is the measure 2 or 3 questions are of trapezium. So we first time here discussing trapezium here. So look the question, what is given here? The length of the parallel side of trapezium are given 60 and 77 meter, and the length of other sides are 25 and 26. Find the area of trapezium. So means all 4 sides are given, but you know area's formula is what? Half into sum of parallel sides into distance between 2 parallel sides, means altitude. So other 2 sides are not required here. If we draw figure here, then let this is trapezium, let ABCD is there. Now length are given 60 and total here 70. Suppose this is 25 and this BC is 26. Now if you draw here perpendicular from point O, let it M. Same way from B also, let it N. Then this will be 60 because it is rectangle. Okay, now other 2 sides are given. So DM and NC we are not having, but sum of both ones we can say. DM plus NC will be 77 is there. So it will be 17. This plus this remaining 60 is there. How much left? 17. So it will be DM plus NC. Okay. So let find it first of all. So let ABCD be trapezium. And AB parallel CD, because that we have to clear, means just we describe whatever figure we have drawn is supposed. Okay, now AM is perpendicular to CD or DC, and BN also perpendicular to DC. Okay, so now we can say DC equal to 77. But actually what is DC? So DC is nothing but a DM plus MN plus NC equal to 77. We are not having DM, but so let suppose anyone X either here or here. So let I suppose here X. This is already 60, so we can get NC. So let DM be X, MN is 60, Y, just opposite side of this rectangle. NC we are not having, so you can see here X plus NC equal to 17. So NC equal to 17 minus X. So you can write here 17 minus X. Because sum of both these parts is given, not given, but we found 17. So if anyone injects, then obviously second one is total minus first one, means total minus x. Okay, so this is only supposition over. Now you should find height here. So let it is height. Both are equal because distance between two parallel sides is constant. So we drawn here two altitude AM and BN, and they are edge only. Okay, both are equal. Now what to do for finding edge? Because our main purpose is to find height, altitude, distance between these two parallel sides. Because again, I telling you formula, half into sum of parallel sides, they are already given, into distance between two parallel sides, means this altitude. So our main purpose here is to find altitude. Okay, so how to find that altitude, that is our main thing here. So what to do? So now you can see here, this is right angle triangle, this is also, in both one AM and BN are equal. AM and BN are equal. So we start from there only, so that we will have x, and after finding x we can find h also. Okay, so let's AM equal to BN. You can give reason here, distance between two parallel sides. Okay, if you want, you can say that distance between two parallel sides. You can write in full. So I can write AM square is equal to BN square. Why? I don't want to write everywhere square root sign. So initially sides are equal, to their squares are already equal. So now just apply Pythagoras formula here. So obviously it will be 25 square is equal to x square plus h square. So h square equal to what? 25 square minus x square. So I here writing 25 square minus x square. Okay, Pythagoras formula. Same way here, hypotenuse square minus this square. So it will be 26 square minus 17 minus x square. Okay, so we will have x. We will have x. After finding x, we can find h, because h expressions are already two we are having. AM means what? So now you can find, because from one variable, sorry, from one equation you can find one variable. So it will be 625 minus x square is equal to 676. Okay, 26 square is there. Let bracket should be written here. First of all, make here square of binomial, it will be trinomial. So apply x minus y, or a minus b whole square. So it will be a square minus 2ab plus b square. So I write here 289 minus 34x plus x square. Okay, 289 minus 34xy, a square minus 2ab plus b square. Now open that bracket. So it becomes now 625 minus x square is equal to 676 minus 289 plus 34x minus x square. Okay, now we can cancel this minus x square right now. Otherwise, you can shift it to any one side, and then also they can be cancelled. Right now, same signs would be there. Okay, so it is 625 only. It is 16 minus 9, 7. Here 16 minus 8, 8. 5 minus 2, 3. So again, 9 plus 7, 16, 1. 8 plus 8, 16, 17, 1. 3 plus 2, 5, 6. Okay, it is right. 34. Okay, just shift it here, so it will be subtracted. So 15 minus 7, 8. Here 11 minus 8, 3. 5 minus 3, 2. So it will be 34x. So again, 8 plus 7, 15, 1, 9 plus 3, 12, 1, 3 plus 3, okay. Now it will be 238 divided by 34, okay. So just count where it is 238, 34. 3 7s are 21, 3 8s are 20, 3 7s are, let it, so 7 4s are 28, 2, 7 3s are 21 plus 2, okay. So exactly 7 we got here x, but this is x only. Actually we don't want here x finally we want x, okay. So h equal to, you can see either here or here, okay. So now use this x anywhere. So I write here, okay, h equal to under root 25 square minus x square, you know Pythagoras formula, okay. So it equal to 625 minus 7 square means 49, okay. X is used here, so it will be 476, okay, 476. So obviously it will be 24. I given you triplet 24 7 25, so that way you can benefit by memorizing Pythagorean triplets which are repeatedly useful. Now nothing is difficult, just use that formula and find out area, okay. So let's find area also now. So it will be area of trapezium. Is equal to half AB plus CD into either edge or AM or BN, whatever. So is equal to half 60 plus 77 into, we found here 24, okay. So it is 12. So now it is how much? 67137 into 12, okay. Just applied formula of area of trapezium, just putting value, nothing to understand, just mechanical process is left, you have to simplify only, just multiply them. So it will be 1370 into twice. Seven twos are 14, three twos are 6, 7, and two ones are 2. So 4, 4, 5, 6, 1, 1, 6, 4, 4. Okay, 1, 6, 4, 4. Here is meter everywhere, so meter square. So understand well. I repeating everything here, this are rough work, okay. So ignore it. Now look here, first whenever it is geometry sum, I will always draw figure. From figure only I will get many ideas and something so that I can describe here also. So we drawn here trapezium, two parallel sides are taken ABCD, two extra construction are also there. This is, we have constructed extra. Why? Because that must be there, otherwise we cannot find area. So for finding that one, what to do? So we apply Pythagoras formula in this triangle AMD and at B and C also, okay. First of all, we started here, how to suppose that one, let's discuss first of all that total is 77. In this one, first part, second part, third part, any one part is supposed x, so I supposed here dm. So x plus 60 plus this equal to 77. So we got here nc and it is placed here. Now in both ones, perpendicular distance mean altitude are obviously equal. So we have written am square is equal to bn square. Now according to Pythagoras, we have written Bode's formula. Okay, then nothing is there, just it is simplified. And after getting x, we found here h. Pythagoras formula apply. You can apply here also, no problem. Okay, so we got it h. But that is our main purpose here. After getting altitude, we can find very easily area of trapezium because both sides are priorly given. Okay, so at last we found area. It is 1644, actually double lines by mistake done here. So understand 1644. Okay, so understand well, and if you want, can take screenshot also. Okay, we just solve this one. Okay, now read this question again. It is somewhat different. Okay, so understand it well and read twice what is given. Okay, and try to understand it. Hello, you can see here again trapezium is there, but here area is given. Area is given. Two parallel sides also given, and they want non-parallel sides. Difference of non-parallel sides is again given. You can see second line, one of the non-parallel side is 2 meter less than the other. Find the length of non-parallel sides. So again, let me draw first of all figure only. Same thing, ABCD, just like previous one here also you can go ahead, but it will be quite difficult because here x, x minus something, here y minus 2. In quadratic equation it is very difficult. Okay, because here also like this, let's try. We will not follow this method, but I just telling you something. Suppose just like previous one, we want to solve here. So it will be 16, so it is also 16, total 30. Okay, so if this is x, then remaining 14 minus x will be here. Now if you take here y, because that is us, then you can write here y minus 2 or y plus 2 also, no problem. So I think h you will get, you can, because area is given, so you will have h also. Okay, you can get it, it is possible 12 here. But even after getting height, altitude, to solve this equation becomes difficult. Why? Because here y square is equal to x square plus 12. Here y minus 2 square is equal to 12 square plus 4 minus x square. So it will be quadratic expression. Inside of that one, y square will also be there, y also. X square and x also there. So how to replace x square and x, y square and y? If any one is there, you can. Only y square or only x square, only y or only x is there, you can. But at a time, square is there and only y or only x is also there. So this method can be applicable. You can find, no problem, because for getting two variable, two equation we should have, and two equation we will have. So obviously we can find, but that method becomes very complicated and somewhat lengthy also. So if you want, you can try. What types of problem arise, you can see or you can observe. But now instead of going to that way, Pythagoras way, let's take another method. So what to do? Because area is given, that's why here. So let's remove this one and just look here. Again, I drawing trapezium, but not drawing here altitudes. This is 16, this is 30, total 30. Instead, I just draw here one line, let it E, BE, so that this become parallelogram. So ABED becomes parallelogram. Obviously, in parallelogram also, opposite sides are equal. Now you can say this side. So it will be 30 minus 16. So obviously it will be 14. Why? Total is 30. So 16 plus 14, 30. So you got this. Now, if you suppose here anything, suppose x, then this will be also x. Why? Opposite sides of parallelograms are equal. And you can write here x minus 2 or x plus 2 anyway. I writing x minus 2. Understood? So now total area is given. Total area is given. How much? 276. 276. So if you have area of this triangle, then you can find x from here. So how to find it? Because we are not having area of this parallelogram. So for that purpose, first of all, find height. After getting height, you will know what will be the area of this part. Then you can find out that. So first of all, here area is given. So I writing here half AB plus CD into H. So let's draw it here. Okay, not giving name here because not useful, just as we given, otherwise if you want, you can say. So it is given 276 is equal to half 16 plus 30 into h. We want to find height only, altitude only. So 276, it will be half 46, okay, into h. So it will be 23. So 276 upon 23. So it will be 23, 1s are 23. And 4 left, 46, 23, 2s are. So this we got 12. So now I can say area of parallelogram. So we have to first of all, suppose here we just doing extra construction here. So construct BE, so write down here. This is my first part. I write here construct BE parallel to AD. BE parallel AD. So, therefore, ABED is parallelogram. Okay, now I can find area of parallelogram. Why? I have base and altitude also. Altitude we found from area only. Because if something is given, it is not given unnecessarily. Something you should be there. So why they have given 276? Because we can get altitude from that. And using that altitude, you can find area of this parallelogram. After getting this one, you can find area of this triangle also. So now, I can say area of ABED equal to base into altitude. So base D into altitude AF. Okay, D is base and that is 16. Okay, so it is equal to 16 into 12. So 160 plus 32, 192. 192 everywhere meter is there. So it will be meter square. So if it is 192, you can find this one, because whole trapezium area also given. So now you can say, therefore, area of BCE is equal to area of whole trapezium ABCD minus area of parallelogram ABED. So it is given 276 and here given 192. Okay. So 6 minus 2, 4, 17 minus 9, 6. So it is 64. Sorry, 8. 17 minus 9, 8. So 84 meters square. Okay. So you got here area 84. Now, using Heron's formula, you can find x, and so x minus 2 also means both parallel sides you will have. Okay, so this second method is, I think, more convenient to us. In that one, complication might be arise due to complicated equations. So understood, now it is 84. Sides are what? X, x minus 2, 14. Okay, x, x minus 2, 14. So let's now count and try to find x by Heron's formula. So what will be S? So in triangle BCE, S will be how much? X plus x minus 2 plus 14 divided by 2. So it will be 2x plus 12 divided by 2. So it will be x plus 6. Okay, both are divided by 2. So this is S. Now you should apply Heron's formula. S, A, B, C, everything we will have. Okay, so just remember, we have x plus 6 s, this is x, 14 and x minus 2. We're going to next page and just do work there, because now it is enough. So before going to next part, just take screenshot here, and now we apply Heron's formula. Okay, remember here, because we are going to at next page, so area is 84. This is x plus 6. Sides are x, x minus 2 and 14. So remember it. Okay. Okay, okay, so question is same only. So I writing area 84 is here. So this is next question, but not look here. Okay, now I just giving you hint, only starting steps I just giving you. Look here, you will have A is equal to S, S minus A, S minus B, S minus C. Area we already have 84. It will be x plus 6. S is x plus 6. This is x plus 6 minus A. Let A be x. Then x minus B. So S is x plus 6, B. So B let it 14. Then S minus C. Minus C is x minus 2. So minus x plus 2. Okay, you get it. Now just simplify it. 84 is equal to under root. X plus 6 remain x plus 6. XX cancel out. Here it is x only. So it will be 6. Now x minus 8 here. X minus 6 minus 14. And here XX gone. So 6 plus 2, 8. Okay, so how much it is? Let's see. So it is 84 is equal to under root 48 x plus 6 x minus 8. Now square both sides. So it will be 84 into 84. I squaring both sides for removing this square root. So is equal to 48 x plus 6 x minus 8. Now just shift it here. 48 to be there. Okay. So it will be 84 into 84 upon 48 is equal to x plus 6 x minus 8. Okay, so 12 7 ja. Okay, and here 12 4 ja. Now 4 into 2, 4 into 1. So it will be 7 1 ja 7, 7 1 4 7 is equal to x plus 6 x minus 8. Now just you can find it. Multiply both of them also. Then get standard form of quadratic equation. After getting standard form of quadratic equation, you can find it. Okay. So now onward. So again, whole sum I just explaining again. First of all, we by extra construction here try to solve. And first of all, altitude we can find, so we found it altitude and place here also. I constructed B parallel to AD so that ABED becomes parallelogram. Now that parallelogram's area we can find base into altitude. Base is D, altitude is AF. AF we already found, this is given. So we got is 192. Now whole trapezium's area is there. In from parallelogram's area is removed, so you can find area of this triangle BC also. Now you can apply your Heron's formula. So we started for Heron's formula. First of all, we found S semi-perimeter. Formula is applied. All values are placed here. You whatever we got at last is this, and we reach up to that stage. Now you just multiply both of them. Shift this 147 also there. Again, you have to factorize. Again, now these are not factor because opposite side should be 0. Okay, so you just multiply, means remove bracket, open bracket, 147 should be at that side. Again factorize, and then you will have value of x. Okay, after getting value of x, you can find this side and then this side also. If two values are there, some because quadratic equation you two soil, if negative is there, neglect it. If some number which is very bigger, then neglect it. Okay, But mostly we take positive value whichever you obtain after quadratic. So sum is not over. You just go ahead and find it. Okay, so whatever so far we are having, let's see here. Take screenshot if you want. And then we go for next sum. Okay, so how many tiles are required to cover a footpath of width 1 meter? So width is given, but it is around any rectangle. So this is the path outside of it. Okay, roughly I try to show it here. Just look here. Now they have given, this is the grass plot. And its measurements are given 28 and 18. This is 28 and this is 18. Okay, so actually this path is found indirectly, not directly. How? If you take outer rectangles area, and out of this outer rectangles area, if you subtract area of this grass plot, means inner rectangle, then you will have that required area. You know that very well. So what will be measurement of this outer rectangle? So let's see here. Its width is given 1 meter. So 1 meter here, 1 meter here. To 2 meter increase. So it will become 30 meter here. Why? Because 1 plus 1, 2 meter increase. Breadth also 1 plus 1. So it will be 20 meter. Okay, so now you can find area of that path particularly, not of grass plot, because that is not us. So first of all, find that only, because that is ask only. How many tiles? That is later things, not discuss right now tiles. Just find area for that one. So area of path equal to area of outer rectangle minus area of inner rectangle, otherwise of grass plot. Okay, so it will be 30 into 20 minus 28 into 18. Where from 30 and 20 came, you can write here also. Okay, otherwise you can write directly. It is 600 minus 28 into 18. 8 is 64, 6. 8 is 16 plus 6, 24. So 4, 12, 5. 5 to 4. This is 5 to 4. Okay, now sorry, it is 22 here. 8 is 64, 6, 8 is 16 plus 6, 22. So it will be 4, 0 here and here 5. So 5, 0, 4. Okay, so it is 96 meter square. So this is the area. Now they have given 20 centimeter square tiles, but it is meter square. Now how to convert meter square into centimeter square? You know, 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. So obviously 1 meter square is equal to 100 square centimeter square, not 100. So it will be 10,000. So if you multiply this by 10,000, then it will be centimeter square. Okay, so it will be 960,000. Okay, just like that, 960,000 will be there, centimeter square. I multiply by 10,000. Why? Just understand that. Okay, now how many tiles are required? So now you can use cross multiplication step. Otherwise, directly also you can see this area divided by 20, because it is area of one tiles area given, not side. Okay, so number of tiles equal to number of tiles required ₹9,60,000 upon 20. So 10 gone, here 48 and 000. So 48,000. So 48,000 tiles will be required there. Okay, so understand it well. First of all, how to find these types of area, that you have to understand. Then we found here 30 and 20 are the measurement of 30 and 20 are the measurement of outer rectangle including path. So how to find this area, boundary area, how to find? Not directly. So outer rectangles minus inner rectangles area, so we found accordingly. But here is centimeter square, so we have to convert here cent, because unit should be equal. So I multiply by 10,000. Okay, now just divided by 20, because one tiles having area 20 cent, but we have so much long or large area, so just divided by 20. So how many tiles are required, we got. Okay, so get it and note it down also. In same type of questions are given in example also. Okay, you can serve example. Only two examples are new. I will solve here. Otherwise, almost all examples are repeating up. Those I have solved here in exercise, same type of questions given with solution as an example. So you just go through them. Okay, now understand, this is very important question. Rectangular park is 65 meter long and 50 meter wide. Two cross paths each of 2 meter wide are to be constructed parallel to the sides. If this path pass through the center of the rectangle, and cost of construction is ₹17.25 per square meter, find total cost involved in the construction of path. But cost is not now useful, it is the point we discuss later on. Now we have to find first of all area of that crossroad. So what is the matter? So read again, there is a park. So I just draw here park. Okay, so their measurements are given here, 65 and 50. Now how this is the center, so two crossroads are constructed there, one is that way and another one is like this. Okay, if you remember, try to recall, in standard 7 you studied this type of question. Okay, so basically width is also given 2 meter, so this is 2 meter here, 2 and here also 2. Okay, this is the width. So obviously this is rectangle, this is also rectangle, so this rectangle's measurement will be 65 length 2 breadth, here 50 length 2 breadth, because it is just parallel to one side and this is parallel to this side. So length is already taken from here, width is fixed to here. Now again consider one thing extra, in this path and this path, this square of 2 centimeter side is repeating, that square is repeating, means it is in both ones. Okay, so we will find area of this both roads by getting area of this path, and then subtracting area of that square. Why? It comes twice. So remove once. Okay. So now directly we find that area. So area of what is given there? Path. Okay. So area of path equal to. Area of both rods together minus, sorry, ROID is minus area of square at center. Okay, so first will be 65 into 2 plus. Second will be 50 into 2, and this square having 2 square means 2 into 2. Okay, so it is very simple, just it is quite takes time for understanding the matter, but then after it is means calculation is very simple. So 130 plus 100 minus 4. So it will be 230 minus 4. So 226 centimeter square. Okay, 130, 52 is 100 minus 2 square 4. So 230 minus 4, 226. Now we can find cost, because per square meter it is given. Sorry, meter square, not centimeter square. Okay. Now find cost. So cost equal to 226 into 17.25. Okay, I remove point also. So if you want, okay, by 25 it is divisible, so let's divide it. 25 4 ja. Now 25 6 ja. 150, 22 left. So 9. So 69. So you just 113 here and here too. Now not cutting is possible. Okay, again verify 25 4 ja, 25 6 ja, 150, 22 left, 225, 25 9 ja, okay, here 113. So 69 into 113 by 2. I not doing right now, whatever you will get, that will be your answer. Okay, because time short is, and not go through calculation, you. Okay, so understand it. This is a very important topic and question. And same type of question today I am going to give you in homework also. So it is very simple. Draw figure, then you can understand both rods, both sides, length as well as breadth. Breadth is equal only. Okay, so 65 parallel, so length 65. Now this is parallel to 50, so length 50. Then square should be subtracted because it is repeating. So remove once, removed. After that, just multiply by rate. So we got cost. Okay, this is just like that. So it is in homework. Okay, so question number 23 in homework, remember. Okay, now Okay, now 24 also you can do. Find the carpeted area. So actually I just giving you hint. Okay, 23 and 24 both, this is okay. Now it is this area, okay, 7 5.6, but leaving 0.3 meter space bar all around, so carpeted area will be what? So use this subtract here. We solved this type of sum already there. So now you should subtract here 0.3 and 0.3. So 7 minus 0.6, so it will be 6.4. this will be length of this carpet. Okay, this is carpeted area. I subtract 0.6, why? Because both sides 0.3 0.3 is removed. Now 5.6 minus 0.6, so it will be 5 only, so it will be 5. Understood? So it's very simple, just understand question. So find the carpeted area, just multiply them. Okay, so today only two sums, question number 23 and 24 in homework of lecture number 5. Okay students, so now we end our today's lecture here only. Just two sums I have given in homework, and remaining sums and two or three example I have identified which are somewhat different than remaining others, we will solve in next lecture. Okay, thank you very much.